Absolutely. I'm sure that most actors during pilot season feel like they wish they can get on a yacht and just get out of the way. Because it's so, so unbearable. True. Exactly, right? Right? Yeah, I think that is a dream.
And just it's, escape it all.
Yeah, exactly. Idealistic and, you know, it's kind of something romantic about it all, mm-hmm. about starting over.
But that's what's happening this season for us. It's just, it's reinvention. It's a mass exodus from Los Angeles. We lose our home and we're basically refugees on the water.
That everyone, they come together and get on this boat because they are hopeful. There is a glimmer of hope. There has to be in order for survival of our species.
I think they're in survival mode, but yep. beyond that, I think they're still looking to, at this point, to start over. Mm-hmm. I just kind of enjoy the ride. I don't think about if my character's going to make it. Occasionally I do, you know, but, you know, we're actors. We're used to, you know, moving through jobs and on to the next, you know. But I do love this job, and I hope my character sticks around. I hope she survives for a while.
I think she will. Yeah. And I think it's really good for us to stay in the moment. You know, it's like, I mean, I think that's how we even get our scripts. We don't know so much in advance, because it's important for us to like be in the moment as we would in an apocalypse, and that's really strong.
I mean, I feel like they've barely even had time to process it, really. There's so much that's happened. I mean, Alicia's lost a boyfriend, she's lost her neighbor, she's lost the whole potential of her life to go in one direction has very quickly changed. So I don't know that she's really had time to process and grieve properly, but I think, yeah, that will probably come in time, change the way she is.
I think Nick's in pretty good condition going into season two. I think he's obviously kicked the drugs and seems to be quite optimistic, I think.
I think these characters, though, they don't know that it's complete end times yet. I think Nick and maybe Daniel Salazar, they have an idea in Strand that this is the end. But for the rest of them, they are definitely driven by hope.
We're at a similar situation. Yeah. Our characters are handling it differently, but both of us have recently lost our mothers. Mm-hmm. We're at odds with our fathers for one reason or another. So in a strange way, because we don't have siblings, we're almost orphaned in a way, because we don't know who to trust in this new world and with these strangers.
And
so we're at a bad place.
That's one of the hardest things to accept too, is because when you have pain, you know, pain is, you know, that's the beautiful things about friendship, is that they're supposed to carry their pain with you so that we could grieve with them properly.
Right.
And we don't have that proper friendship to grieve to someone to carry that pain with us.
Right.
And it creates so much trauma into your
and
psychology.
Yeah. They're
Everyone's
so sweet.
Nuts.
Yeah. The best is the when they're eating. So they're
yeah.
completely like gore, like missing like half their face, and then they're like eating a fry.
Yeah.
It's so amazing.
You see
my
craft service, they're
yeah.
like, how's it going?
Yeah.
I don't want this sandwich anymore. Thank you for ruining my lunch.